I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, sitting with us through Nityananda TV, Lotus TV, Sadhana TV, Janashree TV, two-way video conferencing, and Ishwar TV. Sitting with us in two-way video conferencing, Toronto Kailasam, Guadalupe Rameshwaram, Seattle Chidambaram, Singapore Singapuram, Nityananda Nagara Bididi, Nityananda Nagaramu Hyderabad, Ohio Prayag, San Jose Madurai, Oklahoma Somanatham, San Diego La Jolla, Bangalore North Sharjah, Thiruvanmiyur Chennai, Kathmandu Nepal, Enriching Temple Bididi, Winnipeg Canada, Oman Sivagangai, Thiruvanmiyur Dhyanapeetam, Bangalore North Sharjah, San Diego La Jolla. I welcome all of you with my love and blessings. Today, 13th day in our awakening. We will be working on pouring life energy into your personal reality. I wanted to give the essence of the inner awakening sessions happening in today morning satsang. First thing, I wanted even all of you to listen. Please listen. Don't think just because you are doing the session, you know everything. Listen. Because some of the very important truths, clicks you will get now. The first thing you need to understand, putting yourself in other person's place, especially when you start thinking through for the other person, to cause other person's reality, to make other person's reality express, to make other person's reality into reality. First thing happens is expansion to you. Please listen. When you create a space to make others' reality into reality, when you become a catalyst for others to realize what they want to realize, when you become a cause for others to experience their realities, the first thing happens is you expand. You expand. You become larger space. You become a larger being. Please listen. When you decide, you will cause your family's realities. You became a head of a family. When you decide, you will cause your reality, you became a human being. When you decide, you will cause your city's reality, you became a leader of the city. When you decide, you will cause the reality for the country, you became head of the country. When you decide, you will cause the reality for the world, you become God. When you decide, you will cause the reality for the universe, world, you become God. So deciding to cause others' reality, deciding to cause others' reality is what I call responsibility. That is what I call enriching. You putting yourself in others' place and thinking through and deciding, I'll cast it. All the devotees all over the world, all the devotees all over the world need to know, yesterday we were having a long sharing session about possibility. Business schools teaches you only how to be busy, not how to do business. Really. They only teach you how to be busy. Just being busy is not that. Being busy does not mean doing business. I tell you, real business is being a cause for everyone's reality. Being a cause for everyone, everyone's reality. I tell you, when you decide I'll be a cause for everyone to experience their reality, suddenly you see so many people cause what you want as reality. Sometimes what you think is comfortable only is most uncomfortable thing. Listen, yesterday so many Swamis were sharing what they are seeing, what they are learning, everything. What they were seeing and what they were learning, the understanding about the reality. I tell you, when you create the expanded phase, expanded space, and the expanded phase of you, when you created an expanded space where you are able to think through for everyone's reality, with that expanded space, when you, if you look at your personal reality, you will see just like that you can make it as reality. You can see very clearly, just like that you can make your personal reality into reality very easily. Your personal reality is not at all a difficult one. Continuously, when you decide, you will cause others' reality. I tell you, that will open up tremendous love, life energy in you. How many words I use, how many ways I tell you, when you start only you will understand the experience. The person who lives with the hum, 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 suffers. The person who lives with tum, 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 celebrates. Tum means you, 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 you. Somebody asked me a question. What if others want to cause in their life is going to harm them or hurt them? Then if I cause that in their lives, am I not harming them? How can that be enriching? Or am I missing something? Did Swamiji mean that we need to listen to what they say they want to cause, what their being really wants? Please listen. Be very clear whether you support or not, they are going to cause what they want to cause in their life. Is it not? When you don't want to cause, you create this judgment, justification. No, 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 it is harming them. Who are you to justify? Give love, not intelligence. Be a hand, be an extra hand for them, not extra head. If that is what they want, give them that, that's all. Be extra hands for people, not extra heads. I always tell people, we need only hands and legs, not heads. That we have enough. Be hands and legs for people, not heads. Many times we justify, because we don't want to support the other person, we don't want to be a cause for other person's reality, we just try to justify saying, no, 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 it may be it is harmful to him. No. Relax. Yesterday, if you listen to all the Swami's sharings, the underlying current, you would have got one thing. I constantly make what you think as impossible as possible by demonstrating in my life within the laws of human realm. Within the rules and regulations of the human beings, within the laws of human beings. When I play chess, I don't bring cricket rules. When I play chess, I move the coins, not that I take the bat and hit the coins. I know the game I am playing. When I am playing human, I play human. When you want healing, I am not going to be playing human. I'll play divine. The game of that rules is different. But when I ask you to comb your hair and have a proper hairstyle, I'm going to play human. To clean your hair, to clean your head, I may play divine. But to clean your hair, I'll play human. I know the rules of the game. Constantly making any impossibility into possibility by playing that within the human laws and rules, regulations, is my job. If you listen, underlying current from everyone sharing, that's what you will understand. Ability. Ability to be a cause for everyone's reality. Actually, it is a powerful training. You need to know one more important truth. Please understand, many of the recent neurological researchers are proving what I am saying. Understand, I am giving it like a formula. Either you are multidimensional or no dimensional. There is no such thing as perfection in single dimension. No. Either you are multidimensional, means you are able to think for everyone, or no dimensional, you can't even think for you. Somebody else thinks for you. Either you are multidimensional or no dimensional. Understand? Either you are multidimensional or no dimensional. Either you are able to think for everyone or you can't think for even yourself. When you start thinking for everyone, you develop that beautiful faculty, that quality. It is actually through active thinking you reach the thoughtless space, not the other way. It is through the active thinking you achieve no mind space, not through the other way. It is through the active thinking you achieve the right space. I can see very clearly, even in the life of my sannyasis and ashramites, whoever learns to teach, learns to do puja, learns yoga, everything, they are able to support everyone else also. And whoever is taking up the responsibility of supporting everyone else, they learn everything in their life also. Whenever these fellows behave selfishly, my department, my, me, I have seen they destroy themselves and disappear, run away. Yogo nashtaparantapaha. Running away is what finally happens to them. Running away is the self-destruction. Cause, others' reality, rule, life by power, not by fear. Politics is all about ruling life by fear, creating fear in everyone. If you don't do this, if you don't listen, you'll be put in jail. ruling people by fear, ruling resources by fear, controlling resources by fear is politics. The more you frighten people legally, bigger leader you become. That's all. Spirituality is all about ruling by power, means being a cause for others' reality. Here also you become powerful by enriching, not by encroaching. Go on enriching, become more and more powerful by enriching, not by encroaching. Become more and more powerful by enriching, not by encroaching. Listen. It's like either he can say, did you see the scar in his face? I did it. Or did you see the crown on his head? I gifted it. You can remember, you can be remembered in any way you want. Somebody asked me the question, if being a hand in fulfilling others' reality gives me a personal satisfaction, then is this considered as a hidden agenda? No. That personal satisfaction is called completion. That is not agenda. That is your right. That is the space you have to be in. That is your right. Go on, go on, go on. Be the cause for fulfilling what others want as reality. If you are a priest, be a divine channel for everyone to experience their reality. Only then you will see you are integrated to your profession. Whether you are doing puja or homa, be cause for others to realize their reality. If you are a doctor, be cause for others to realize health when you live. Start living. When you start living, being a cause for others' reality, then you'll understand what I am saying, the amount of energy expressing, the intensity coming out, intelligence expressing, how you become the source of energy, intelligence, knowledge, unimaginably everything expressing. Let's move to the Upanishad, mirroring the neuron activities of the cosmic super brain, macrocosmic brain. Namah Shivaya.
Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 080-2727-9999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.